Hi, this is Scott from RedmondPhysicsTutoring.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how to calculate the force on a current carrying wire. The basic idea is that we're given a segment of wire of length L carrying a current I in a magnetic field B, and we have to find the force on that wire, the magnetic force on that wire. There are two expressions that we use for this. The first one, we have FB is equal to IL cross B. In this expression, I is the current, L is the length of the wire segment, B is the magnetic field, and then F sub B is the magnetic force. And the only tricky thing about this is that the L term is actually a vector. You notice that it has the arrow on top. And we choose the direction of vector L to be in the positive direction of the current. Now, the L cross B is just the vector cross product, so it's also possible to write this in terms of the magnitudes, in which case we would have FB is equal to ILB sine theta. And again, I is the current, L is the length of the wire segment, B is the magnetic field, and FB is the magnetic force. So the only new thing, if we're going to use the second equation in terms of magnitudes, is that we have to think about what that angle theta is. And theta is the angle between vectors L and B. And you can use either of these expressions, depending on your preference. I'm not going to go into the proof for this right now. It's not a very difficult proof, but I don't want to take up your time with that. I will include it in a very inexpensive video course that I'm preparing right now as I'm recording this. All right, let's look at an example. A 2.5 meter wire carries a 7 amp current in a direction 40 degrees east of north through a magnetic field that is 3 teslas west. Find the magnetic force acting on the wire. We're given that the current is 7 amps. We're also given that the wire is 2.5 meters long. And we're given the magnetic field as being 3 teslas to the west. We're also given the direction of the L vector as 40 degrees east of north. Looking at the given data, I want to actually also consider which equation is going to be easier to use. So first I'll check out I times L cross B, because we have the L vector and we have the B vector. And then I'm going to also consider FB in terms of the magnitude is equal to ILB sine theta. Looking at the first one, FB is equal to IL cross B, I have the L vector, I have the B vector, but it's not immediately obvious how to set up that cross product. And as with all physics problems, I really need to do a sketch for this. Because the directions are expressed with respect to east, north, and west, I'm going to actually draw out north, east, south, west. And I know that this is going to be a 3D problem, just because these often are. So I'll have north, east, south, and west, and I've drawn it like this at an angle because the north, east, south, west are all in the horizontal plane. We also have directions down into the ground and up towards the sky. Okay, so with respect to these directions then, I need to draw this out. L is 2.5 meters 40 degrees east of north. So that means I start north and then I go 40 degrees towards the east. Like that. And then I can draw my L vector. So the L vector is between north and east, and it's actually 40 degrees rotated away from north, which means that it would be 50 degrees from the east if we were to add those up, because north and east should be 90 degrees apart. The next thing is to look at the magnetic field, which is to the west. Looking at the diagram, it's easier for me to use the second form of the equation because I know the current, I know the length, and I know the magnetic field, so the only unknown is the angle between them. Now that angle between them, remember, it's really tempting when you see a problem like this to just take what angle is given. In this case, we're given 40 degrees. And it's tempting to pump in that 40 degrees and then just say, all right, I got the right answer. But unfortunately, it's actually not true. The angle that you need to use is between L and B. The angle 40 degrees is between L and north. So this angle theta is actually equal to the 90 degrees, which is between west and north, plus 40 degrees. So theta is actually equal to 130 degrees. So I substitute that in, 130 degrees, and I'm just using red here. I know it violates my color coding, but I'm using red to make it more visible. Then I can solve for this. I know all of those things. And I'll find out that the magnetic force has a magnitude of 40.2 newtons. Now, this is great. A lot of students at this point say, yay, I have the answer, I'm done. And unfortunately, physics teachers, as I'm sure you are well aware, are a little bit more picky. And they might just be picky enough to say, hey, there's a vector on top of that. Force is a magnitude, force is a vector, so it has magnitude and direction. Now, if we're using the second form of this equation, we need to actually use the right-hand rule to get the direction. If we use the first form, IL cross B, then the direction comes out of it, but we have to express L and B using vector notation, typically using unit vector notation, and then the unit vector notation that results from that gives you the direction for F of B. In this case, we use the right-hand rule. So to start using the right-hand rule, we have our fingers along plus L, then we curl those fingers without moving our palm towards B, and the direction your thumb is pointing gives the rough direction of FB. And FB, because it's a cross product, has to be perpendicular to both L and B. So in this case, your thumb is pointing up, and FB is up. Therefore, FB, as the force, is equal to 40 newtons up. And that's our final answer, and hopefully your physics teacher is happy because you've remembered that the force is a vector and therefore it needs direction. I'm Scott Redmond, and I help students pass physics. I really hope this was helpful to you. If it was, please like it in YouTube to let me know.